Welcome everybody to this fantastic stream that we have planned today, and we are going to be looking at some beautiful chess puzzles, and also we'll be trying to solve with the chat.
Okay, beautiful. How are you doing, Rucha? You know, we have met each other in several tournaments, played with you. In fact, guys, Rucha has even beaten me. She's very strong. She's a WIM.
Yes, thank you so much. Yes, I'm a Women International Master, and I do remember playing you, but it was so long back, you know, like playing on the board now feels like another life.
Exactly.
Completely.
Yeah.
But yes, I started streaming last year on Twitch, and I have been, even now I'm on Twitch right now, so it's been great.
Rucha, we are not alone today. Joining us are... Anirban Das Gupta, Vaibhav Sethia, Biswa will join in shortly. They are India's topmost stand-up comedians, very, very popular, but they are in love with chess and they practice chess a lot, and they have improved hugely in last 1 year.
I'm of course following all the streams, not only on Chess Based India, but also all the chess streams, and of course I know all of you, and not only from chess stream, but also before that as stand-up comedians, so I definitely know you all.
She's very strong. She's a WIM, and now she's a very, very well-known streamer. In fact, Rucha, you are the first Indian to be verified as a streamer on Twitch. Isn't that true?
मतलब अलग ही चल रहा है.
The second Indian streamer to be verified on Twitch. I think first is Vidit, but then he shifted to YouTube.
No, so... Vidit is no longer a Twitch streamer now.
Yeah.
Vidit streams exclusively on YouTube. We'll have some beautiful chess positions, 20 of them, and which the chat has to solve.
When I sent this to Sagar, he said that, well, I think my students will accept this challenge and do this on the screen. So let's do this.
Cha, could you tell them what they have to do?
Yeah, so the pawn is one square away from promotion. So the pawn is going to h8, and the position is black to play and draw.
Anirban, do you want to go first?
Yes, King f8.
Okay, King f8. And Viper, what about you?
King f7.
King f7 or King f8. Okay, so one of them has to be right.
Yes.
And do you know what is the logic behind any of these moves? Why we should play f8 or f7?
So that when the knight comes to c7, then it can come to e6 or e8.
Mm-hmm.
And at that, I think the king will then shuffle between f8 and f7.
Yes. So that's right. The king has to shuffle between f7 and f8, but only one is right.
If I just moved my king to f8 once, and then I thought knight c7.
Okay.
And now if I go back up, sorry, not knight c7, knight b6 instead.
Okay.
Yeah, knight b6. And if I go f7 now, which is forced, then knight... D7 just finishes.
Yes, and now it controls f8 square.
Yeah, and if I go to f7, then the order is like kind of working in my favor.
Yes, so it's the idea is that you have to play the king on the same color square as the knight is. And the idea once again is that the knight piece cannot lose a tempo in the chessboard at all. So you can make waiting moves with any other pieces, but knight every move has to shuffle between light square and dark square. And now even if the knight moves throughout the whole board, you can never lose the tempo. So king f8, knight d7, king f7, and now knight is the one who has to move. And knight moves anywhere, and once again king f8. And that's how black achieves draw here.
But I think this is something which you guys will enjoy. What do we have to do here?
Okay, so this in this white has definitely a lot of material advantage, but this one is white to play and mate in three moves.
Ooh.
I think rook g3, then e3 is forced, mm-hmm. then queen g7, and bishop takes on g3, and then queen d7 is made.
Whoa,
but look, that is not forced to take the rook there.
No, I mean, even if it's not forced, like, I mean, any other move.
But Black can play here, bishop c7, that's the problem.
This was his idea, this was Vaibhav's idea, and Rucha is saying bishop c7 here. Ooh, yes. And it, you have to mate on the next move, Vaibhav.
Oh,
and then, hey, I got it.
Are
ya. Kya kiya yaar tum log ne?
I was thinking queen, rook c3.
Okay,
rook c3, e3 is the only move for Black.
Yes, and then queen to the 7th rank.
And now I'm going to be very tricky, and I'm going to just give you a check, bishop h2 check, and your three moves are over.
Oh man, okay, thank you very much.
Mere paas koi alfaaz nahi hai, mujhe maaf kar de aap log sare, mujhe chutti de de.
So these collections are from my files which I have collected over years, and also some books, so from various resources.
Nice. Is this a composition, or what is this like?
Yes. This is a composition.
Ah, got it now. Now I got it. Yeah, I'll go rook g3.
Okay.
So rook g3, pawn e3.
Yeah, queen c8.
It's a stalemate. It's time to shake hands, and it's a draw.
Okay. Just one last try I will do. Queen g7.
Okay.
Okay. So bishop h2 check.
I sense that it's not solved.
yeah. So then I take the bishop.
Okay.
Then
second
move. G1. Let's make a bishop.
Okay. Let's see
what the hell is happening here. Okay.
गजब बेइज्जती है.
First move, rook h3.
Okay. I'm forced to push the pawn.
Yes, that is the only move for Black, and here we play the brilliant move rook h1. And now you see, we are again forcing Black to capture this
only
rook.
Move. This is pinned here.
That's it. Yes.
So take.
And you take it. And then queen takes h1. That's GG. That's GG.
Beautiful, right?
Wow.
Yes.
I was thinking of h1, but I just did not know how to get the rook. I was thinking, if I get the queen, then it will die. What?
Yes. So it was difficult as well as easy.
From a game, or is this like
this is a composition? So this is white to play and win. And before we start solving this, we should know that in theory, a rook versus knight is a draw in theory.
Hello, Mr. Biswa, how are you?
Hello, Biswa, welcome to the stream.
Hi, hello, Richa, nice to meet you.
Yes, so welcome, and we are looking forward to your participation in this contest.
Let's start with Biswa first. What do you want to say?
King c6.
King c6 is Biswa's answer. Okay, what about Vaibhav?
Rook a8.
Rook a8, okay, and Anirban?
Rook a8.
Rook a8.
Okay, so we have two rook a8. Here.
Okay, Rucha, you can cross question them. You know, you can ask Biswa why his move, Vaibhav, Anirban, why they played
okay.
the move.
So first of all, let's see, the other move, king c6, does not work here because it achieves a draw after king takes rook. And then you'd have to take the pawn, and Black takes the pawn, and it will be king versus king in the end.
Oh, so, we're not going for a draw. I thought,
Yes,
you can take the pawn, you can take the knight. So, okay, so rook a8, now Black has a few options. And first I'm going to play is king b7.
Yeah, then,
and,
rook, then should I answer?
Yeah.
Yes.
Rook a7.
Rook a7, amazing. This
hot
is brilliant.
Hot move, nice.
Brilliant. Yes, so king takes a7.
Forged now,
knight.
You have to take
takes knight.
The knight.
King takes knight, king a8.
Take
and we reached a winning pawn in game. So king b8, and then
king
here
a6.
King a6, exactly. And then the pawn promotes.
Yeah.
So let's give a point to both Vaibhav and Anirban, because they both found rook a8.
Amazing. And just to finish off the line, if king a8, king
c8.
If the knight takes, king c6.
White to play.
Right? So this one is a white to play and win.
Anirban, any thoughts?
Bishop f6.
Bishop f6 is Anirban's move. Okay, what about Biswa?
I was thinking bishop g7.
Bishop g7. Okay, and lastly, Vaibhav?
Rook g7.
Rook g7. Okay.
Okay, so let's go from the beginning. So Anirban suggested bishop f6. So again, pawn takes pawn, and we are reaching rook plus bishop versus the rook. So even if you have rook g7 check, king goes to h8, rook takes g6, king h7. So this is the one we were talking about, rook plus. And of course, actually, it is much easier than we said, because rook and bishop are both under attack.
This is pinned here. In order to save yourself, you'll have to go here, and then you lose material. I think this will be an instant draw.
Yes.
So bishop f6, Anirban doesn't work because of fg6. Biswa, your move, bg7.
Bishop g7, and a pawn takes pawn with a check. So now bishop takes rook, and then king takes rook, and this is also a draw because the bishop sacrifices for the pawn in the end.
Okay, now time for an Vaibhav.
Vaibhav's move. So he suggested rook g7 check.
King takes h8.
Only move.
Rook h7. G7.
G8.
And then g7.
Wow, amazing. We found this.
If the king does not take the rook, if king does not take the rook and just moves the rook away, then I give a check and pick up the rook, which is winning.
Yes, exactly. Oh, yeah. Incredible. Attack!
Today Vaibhav is on fire, so now I'm a little bit worried to say this is very tough. But white to play, guys, here. Rucha.
White to play and win, yes.
Oh, white so to play and win. And Rucha, can you also give a small hint? Because it will help them to think in the right direction.
Okay, so in this case, when we say white to play and win, necessarily does not lead to checkmate, but even if you win any kind of material, so it can be queen, rook, or any minor piece, we can still say it's a winning advantage. I'm going to give another hint, so try to think if you can actually trap black's queen.
Whoa, trap black's queen here, guys. This is the big hint here. Vaibhav, would you like to give it a go?
Yeah, it's not getting trapped.
It's not getting trapped, and also I don't think there is a very strong attack coming on the king.
I was thinking queen g2.
So queen g2. Still black has queen f6. Okay, black has two options. So queen f6 or queen h5. So what do you think about queen h5?
So g4.
Okay, so queen takes h4.
Ah, you mean either queen h5, g4, this will hang.
Mm-hmm.
Biswa, what's your move?
Queen h1.
Queen h1 is Biswa's move. Okay, what's the plan?
Queen h5.
Queen h5, bishop e2 maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Or sorry, just g4.
G4 is actually trapping the queen.
Queen trapping.
So let's find another variation.
Queen f6.
So this is the problem variation.
This is beautiful.
Oh, hold on. If then bishop g5, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, bishop g5. If it takes, then we take, and the queen has to go somewhere. But otherwise, there is queen h7 mate.
Yeah, by the way, so move is queen h1, very powerful move. Queen f6, go bishop g5. and queen trap hai, so you have to take the queen and then take and queen fir se attack and mate yahan.
But what if he come? He can't come anywhere. It's done. What a beautiful move.
Very nice, no?
Damn nice.
Fantastic move.
Okay, so this is why to play and win. And I will give you one hint that if this was black to play wins with the same trick.
Oh, so, acha. Bishop?
H5.
Okay. Vaibo?
Same, Bishop H5.
Bishop H5. Okay, Anirban?
Oh, I did not find that.
Acha.
Queen B2.
Okay, you want to check here.
Yes, so Bishop H5, King takes H5.
Queen H7.
Queen H7 check. King G4.
Queen H3.
Queen King F3.
Queen G2.
Yes, exactly. Queen G2, that's correct. And now in this case, we are winning the queen on A8 with a wonderful skewer in the end. Good job.
Beautiful.
Bishop H5 is right. We should give points to Bishop H5.
Vaibhav, you also saw the full variation, right?
Yeah. Yes.
And also, yeah. If it was black to play, toh kaise?
Bishop H3.
H3.
Yes, so the exact symmetric idea we have.
Very nice.
But king versus king and queen is draw, no?
What? क्या तुम लोगों ने भी वही सुना जो मैंने सुना?
हाँ, what? नहीं जोक था सच. Please don't give me shock.
That's what Sagar taught us. King versus king and queen is draw. That's why I'm losing so many matches.
King versus king and queen. I just published a video teaching how to checkmate.
मजा आया और मैं ये जो मजा है हिंदुस्तान के हर व्यक्ति को देना चाहता हूं.
Okay, let's do this. So this is a white to play and win. Yes.
Rook G2.
Okay.
Rook G2. Then queen check.
No, I mean.
So first of all, I want to see what happens if queen takes G2.
Then D4.
Then queen E4 check.
This is a mate. According to Anirban, it was a mate, but Anirban forgot that the queen can come in between.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
Check, counter check, and then pawn endgame. Haar jaoge because this is all lost.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
My answer was also the same.
Okay. Biswa, okay, do you have a different move? Okay.
I have a different move.
Okay, go for it.
Rook F2.
Mm-hmm. All right. So now king has two options: G6 and E5.
Oh my god, so, yeah, G6, then rook G2 and
yes, yes, that's correct. Right. So king has okay, to go to E5.
Rook F5, I think.
Wow!
Hold on. Oh. Rook F5, yeah.
Rook F5 is correct. Rook F5.
How did you find it, Biswa?
Wow.
I don't know how I found it, but I found
Wow, this is really amazing. Wait, now so black has two options. King takes the rook. And here,
D4
is checkmate.
There is a
word,
if pawn
takes,
that's checkmate. If pawn takes, then D4, he has to go to D5 or
E4? Oh, E4 you can't go, right? Yeah.
So yes, now
so,
this.
Oh, and then the queen is lost. Nice.
Bishop A2, and this is amazing.
Wow.
Well done, Biswa, in finding Rook F5. Rook F5 was incredible. Incredible. So white to play and draw.
Okay, it's doable. Any hints, Rucha?
Okay, so first hint I want to give.
I don't think hints are needed. I don't think hints are
yeah,
needed.
Yeah, let's not do. Let's do one round without
hints. Here.
Yeah.
अरे इधर hint. Hint के बिना थोड़ा tough है.
Let's try without it ना, like तो फिर आप
sure.
Oh, it's so complicated.
क्या करें?
पॉन को कैसे, हाउ डू यू स्टॉप इट?
अरे क्या फालतू चीजें क्यों बोलते हो बीच में?
हां यार प्ले करता.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
How do you stop the pawn?
अरे The G7 square, you need to protect it right now. On this game, G7 is the most crucial point.
I'm helping you guys. I'm saying, how do you stop the pawns? Aap log bol rahe ho, important hi nahi hai.
Okay, so Rook C1, now let's see what happens after Rook C1. So Rook C1 here, if we promote to a queen, of course it's a stalemate because now king can't move anywhere. But here black has a fantastic resource and the black here promotes with a knight.
Which everyone missed.
Yes, everybody missed.
Of course, how can there be a quirky puzzle round without a knight promotion?
Yes, so now king takes bishop and just knight goes to F4 and then black brings the king near and then after that the pawn will promote in the end. And you see that when the knight is supporting the pawn from back, you can never capture it. Because
if you take
then pawn moves. And
this is so weird, like promoting to a knight is like, how can you consider ki bowler aake underarm bowling bhi kar sakta hai? What is this? Yeah. Suddenly.
Also very interesting is if you make a bishop here, if you make a rook, it's a stalemate. If you make a bishop, it's also not winning because now this is a wrong colored square on H1. So this is a draw. So only move that wins is a knight.
Okay. So
there's a different solution.
Yes, so the solution is not Rook C1 and we have similar solution, but we first give Rook A6 check and then we play Rook A1. So the idea is that now when black promotes to a knight, the knight does not reach on time to support H3. So it takes and you see Knight C2 and knight doesn't reach and the pawn is lost. And with single knight, it's a draw.
Beautiful, what a position.
Next, game 16.
Rucha is ready with her next position, which is it tougher than this one, Rucha, or easier?
Easier.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Let's go. This is going to be fun. Guys, white to, this is what?
White to play and draw.
Okay. Let's go. Let's start with Anirban. Anirban, what's your move?
So, I'll move my dark square bishop to g3.
Okay. That's your move.
And the next move basically is light square bishop to f1.
So, what if we go after the pawn, like bishop b6?
Biswa, what's your answer?
My answer is king takes on g1.
King takes g1, then queen takes d6.
Queen is, bishop is 3.
King takes pawn.
मेरा तो इतना लाइफ खराब हो गया है, इतना लाइफ खराब हो गया है मेरा.
Okay, so let's go for the answer. And this looks very unusual, but the first move is here, bishop h2. And now what we are trying to do here is that it looks unusual because we are offering trade of the bishops. So bishop takes, if bishop takes h2. Then bishop h3 here, and now you see if queen takes h3, we are having a stalemate position here. So that's a draw, and let's see other choices for black. So after bishop h2, if black doesn't take, bishop goes anywhere else on this diagonal, doesn't matter, still bishop h3 and queen h3, and again we have stalemate.
Let's go for one more. I don't think we'll be able to complete all 20 positions, but we'll do a couple more, Rucha.
Yes.
And then so maybe we can do another part of this stream.
Okay, sure. Yeah. This is one of the favorites of all the collection today. This is white to play and draw.
okay, let's go. Yeah, like let's go.
Okay.
Let's start with Anirban. Yes.
Queen a4.
Okay.
So now the king has to go to third rank. Mm-hmm.
So f3 or e3. Uh-huh. So let's go f3 first.
Then rook g3, check.
Bishop g3 is.
Oh man.
Queen e5, that's the idea.
Queen e5, bishop e5?
Rook takes e5.
Rook at 6?
I have one more answer.
This is why I was checking rook takes e5 first, but it's somewhere there. The basic idea is we'll give up all our three pieces without him being able to move his king.
Mm-hmm. So you are trying for stalemate. Mm. Trying to give the pieces, yes.
Vaibhav, anything? Oh, you're muted, Vaibhav, you're muted.
I was thinking rook c5.
Rook to
c5. So rook c5 is a check, then rook takes h6 check.
Yeah, and then rook goes back to h5, yeah.
So maybe king g4, check. Or king f3, yeah, king f3. Yeah,
both are.
I have one more try.
Okay, let's try. Let's try.
Rook e5 I was trying, but it also doesn't work.
Rook e5, rook
f6. How about queen e3?
Okay, queen e3. So you're giving a free queen. I will accept it.
Then check g3 check.
You're under.
That's correct. That's exactly the solution. And you know, now the king moves and it's a stalemate no matter what black plays here. So it doesn't matter where the king goes. And the rook and bishop are both pinned. So it's a stalemate. Well done, Anirban. Oh, nice. Well done.
Oh, damn. Well done.
Let's give him 2 points for this one.
Crazy.
No.
Yes. Are 2.5 I'll get Biswa. I got two stalemates. Are what? I got two stalemates.
No. If you attempt twice, then I attempt twice, then Vaibhav attempts twice, then you get 2 points. No. We eliminated 5 possibilities. Okay, then you got it.
I found two stalemates.
2.0.
Okay, let's do another for 2 points and only one attempt.
Okay.
That's it.
Oh, that, okay. I thought that was the rule anyway. No, that rule is introduced now. This for Anirban.
This one got stalemated.
Stalemated.
Difficult because there is some theoretical knowledge also.
No, they will solve it. They'll solve it.
Okay, then go for it.
Let's try.
So, white to play and draw.
Yeah, white to play and win. Okay, let's go. Vaibhav, what's your move?
King c7.
King c7, okay. Biswa?
And King c7.
King c7. And Nirban?
I also have King c7, but I have another answer.
Another bolo.
So you have to guess only one.
Aki.
A4.
Kaunsa bolna hai? King c7 kya
A4?
Okay, but you have to tell the variation. Also, Rucha, you take this forward now. It's very complicated, yeah, here, because it's the last. Yeah.
Okay, so let's start with A4. So, what happens if black has few options? So, let's say black takes, B takes A4.
Then king C7.
Okay, then pawn push, A3.
Only move, yeah? Otherwise, there's no other move.
अरे उधर तक मेरे को समझा कि वो ये वाला जो A5 का पॉन है इसको रोकना है इसलिए A4 करना है बट उसके आगे तक नहीं सोचा था.
Okay, anyway, king c7, shall we just check Runja, like how to, is this also winning or how is it?
Okay, so king c7, black has two options, so a4 and b4. So which one shall we go first?
Any b4 loses, right?
a4.
Okay, let's go b4.
Bishop a4.
b3.
Bishop takes.
Yeah, bishop takes, pawn takes. I think both should win, but there is a
actually,
faster
way. Pawn takes as in like pawn takes and then there is no movement.
It's a stalemate.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Bishop takes is necessary.
He takes.
Okay, now I understood after like watching the other sessions.
Okay, but we can't give him points.
Okay.
You won also.
Oh,
you won.
Now I see the checkmate.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Because
now
we give him chance when he played A4. Now, of course,
nice.
We see the same idea, right? It's the same idea. A3. And bishop A4, A2. And then king C6 and A1. And then bishop B5 is mate.
Damn nice.
Okay, acceptable.
And also, B4 does not win because, I mean, it's the same mate.
King B3 and bishop B7 or bishop B5 is winning.
And just for the sake of completeness, if king B6, then this
bishop
is
B5.
Because the right color pawn, you know, at the end.
And then the
king
will pick up the pawns in the end.
Beautiful.
Damn nice.
Very happy with all three of them. They gave their best. They were trying so hard. And also the chat, who was completely engrossed. They were completely engrossed. But, you know, I knew it when I saw the positions that they will be engrossed because they were so nice. So once again, thanks, Rucha.
Yes.
And all the best with all your streamings. That you are doing, and keep up the great work.
Yes, thank you so much, Sagar, for the stream, and we'll be in touch. And bye, everybody.
See you. Bye.
See you.